For all the brains that Phineas and Ferb have, they missed one of the most remarkable creatures and energy sources of all time. It is understandable that they would miss it because they were in a hurry to finish their trip around the world and they were hopelessly stuck on an island. But what is this remarkable creature? It's this ox. And what is the great energy source that could easily solve the world's energy problems? It's this grass. In the Phineas and Ferb episode, Summer Belongs to You, Phineas, Ferb, Candace, and their friends embark on a trip around the world. Near the end of their trip, they're stranded on an island with very few resources, or so they thought. Phineas devises a plan to build a large paper airplane out of their world map and launch it with a special large rubber band stretched between two palm trees. The power for their launch comes from a lone ox on the island, which pulls back the plane for their launch. And boy, what a launch. The speed of their craft is phenomenal, which gives us a clue that there is something special about that ox. In a previous video, we explored the math behind watching the sunset twice, by quickly going up, perhaps in a very tall building, to watch the sunset a second time. And someone suggested that we could drive or fly fast enough to see the sunset twice as well. But the speeds are insane for most parts of the world. It takes a speed of 1,000 miles per hour, or 1,600 kilometers per hour, just to have the sun appear still when traveling around the equator. But the speed is nothing compared to the speed Phineas and friends are sent flying into the air by that ox. They're flying so fast, the sun is quickly rising above the horizon. So how fast are they moving? Well, based on some measurements from the video, I approximated that the sun took 3 seconds to completely rise. Let's assume the Earth isn't moving and do a quick calculation. Since the sun is half of a degree in the sky and it took about 3 seconds for the sun to rise, then that would mean 6 seconds would be needed to go around 1 degree of the Earth. And since there are 360 degrees in a circle, only 6 times 360 seconds are needed to travel around the Earth. That's 24,000 miles in 2,140 seconds, or about 11.1 miles per second, or in kilometers, about 18.5 kilometers per second. That is fast. How fast? Well, it's past escape velocity, which is the speed that an object needs to be launched to escape the gravitational pull of Earth and never come back. Escape velocity is about 7 miles per second, or 11 kilometers per second. It's good that they had the perfect angle for launch, otherwise they would need to be saved by one of their space friends as they flew out into space. Well, that must have been some ox to put that much energy into the rubber band to launch the plane that fast. It must have been quite a rubber band as well, but we already knew that based on the musical number earlier in the episode that emphasized its super special density. Let's do some calculations and figure out how strong that ox is. We can use a simple physics equation to find out how much energy was put into the paper airplane. If we know the velocity and mass of an object, then we can calculate how much kinetic energy is in the object with this formula. If we use units in kilograms and meters per second, then the energy units we end up with are joules. We've estimated the velocity already at about 18.5 kilometers a second, or 18,500 meters per second. We need an estimate of the mass. Assuming each kid has an average mass of 30 kilograms, Buford pulls the average up here, and the seats also have a mass of 20 kilograms each, then for the 6 kids and 6 seats, it's a total mass of 300 kilograms. That's a total of 51,337,500,000 joules, or about 51.3 gigajoules. That's enough to power over 14,000 average US homes for an hour. But what is amazing is that the ox put that much energy into the rubber band in just a few seconds. That is incredible power. Power is different than energy. Power is how fast energy is used or released. Walking up 3 flights of stairs and running up the stairs takes about the same amount of energy. But one of those people uses the energy over a longer period of time, so the walker has a lower power level than the runner. In short, power is the rate of using energy. Energy is measured in units like joules or foot-pounds or calories or BTUs. But power has different units, watts or horsepower. Each of these is a rate with an energy amount divided by a duration. A watt is a joule per second. A horsepower is 33,000 foot-pounds per minute. Okay, back to the video. Making some inferences from the video, it looks like the length of the rubber band is pulled back is about 4 times the length of the plane and the plane is about 4.5 Candace Flynn's, and Candace is reportedly 173 centimeters tall. So the total distance the rubber band is pulled is about 31 meters. But let's be conservative and round it up to 40 meters, which will require less force from the ox since it's the same amount of energy put into the rubber band, but over a further distance. We should be able to figure out how strong that ox is from all this information. For example, how much force is the ox holding when the rubber band is fully pulled? To find this out, we need to do some rubber band physics. We could start by assuming that the rubber band follows Hooke's law, which is that the force to hold the rubber band is proportional to the distance pulled. In short, that means that the force grows linearly. This is not ideal for calculation. Ideal would be a constant force. Then calculating the amount of energy is easy. We just multiply the force times the distance pulled or pushed. In the US, we often use force in pounds and distance in feet. So carrying a 2-pound weight up 10 feet is 20 foot-pounds of energy. In the metric system, it's often newtons as force and meters as distance. So the unit of energy is a newton meter, which they simplified to just call a joule. But here the force is changing, so it's not as simple to calculate. This kind of problem is typical in second semester calculus classes to illustrate applications of integrals. You can learn more about those in one of our previous videos, where we use an energy situation to discuss the meaning of integration. Physicists don't like having their students do calculus unless absolutely needed, so they use calculus to derive formulas they can just give their students. In this case, they derived this formula, where K is the force to hold the spring or rubber band back one unit of distance, and D is the distance pulled. We don't know K, but we know everything else in the formula, and finding K will let us calculate the strength of the ox. Putting in our values of joules and distance, we end up with a K of 64,171,875 newtons. Now we can finally find out how strong that ox is. If it takes that many newtons to hold the rubber band 1 meter away from the palm trees, it takes 40 times that to hold the rubber band 40 meters away from the palm trees. That calculation is from Hooke's law. So at the end of the pull, that ox is able to exert a force of over 2.5 billion newtons. That's over half a billion pounds, or about 280,000 tons. That's almost the weight of the Empire State Building. Well, 77% of the weight. Now we are really starting to see how powerful this ox is. It can pull weights up to 2.5 billion newtons, and can do so at a decent jaunt. From the time that Phineas starts to pull the rubber band down until the plane is completely pulled back, it took about 30 seconds. That ox is almost strong enough and powerful enough to pull the Empire State Building up 40 meters in just 30 seconds. Let's convert that to watts. A watt, as mentioned before, is a joule per second, so we can calculate the watts the ox is putting out by dividing our total energy in joules by 30 seconds. And that's about 1.7 gigawatts. To put that in perspective, two of these oxen working together would generate more power than all but the 30 largest hydroelectric dams on Earth. It would only take 14 of these oxen to produce more power than the largest power plant in the world, the Three Gorges Dam in China. Five would produce more power than the largest running nuclear power plant in the world. But if these oxen are amazing, what about their food? That energy they are expending is coming from somewhere, and that where is from the grass on this island. Oxen eat about 40 pounds of food a day, or 18 kilograms. The energy density of that grass must be incredible. If it took all of the grass that the ox ate that day to pull the plane back, then the density in joules per kilogram is about 2.8 gigajoules per kilogram. For perspective, that's about 80 times the density of gasoline. It's not quite in the range of the density of uranium, but it is cleaner and safer. All we have to deal with is manure, which is reusable as fertilizer. That estimate of 2.8 gigajoules per kilogram is probably an underestimate. One meal for a typical person would allow them to pull a heavy load for a lot more than just 30 seconds. That grass might be 100 times more potent. If it was 200 times more potent than our low estimate, then it is more energy dense than uranium. Well, with large fields of this power grass and a fleet of oxen, we could easily power the world. Each ox working for 8 hours a day could power over 500 US homes. Perhaps this is not an ethical form of energy, so maybe we can develop a machine that could just run on the grass directly. A fuel with the density of uranium with no radioactive waste. That sounds like something we could use. Phineas and Ferb, could you make one of those machines for us? Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and share our videos. Be sure to follow Math the World on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Thank you so much for your support.